Hello students, welcome to EPG Parthshala. I am Dr. Gunjan from the School of Biotechnology, Gautam Buddha University, Greater Noida. Today we are going to discuss about a module, Conventional Breeding versus Transgenesis, under the paper Plant Biotechnology and Crop Improvement. Now, what are the learning objectives in this module? First of all, we will focus what do we understand conventional breeding? What are the different methods we are using for this breeding method? And what do you understand by transgenesis? And what are the different methods we are using by the process of transgenesis? What are the main goals of these two types of breeding system? What are the steps followed by the breeders during the breeding process in both conventional and the development of transgenic crops? Procedures and the limitations. Further, we also focus on the procedures and the limitations of the conventional breeding. Now, after the conventional breeding, as the scientific work going on, we will enter into the next era of the evolution in the plant biotechnology. This is the transgenics era. That means development of the transgenics crop. In this development process or in the development of transgenics crop, we will study the importance and the regulatory channels of the genetically modified methods in the current scenarios. What are the regulatory bodies which regulate the transgenics crop to release in the market? What are the different types of transgenics crops currently available in the market? What are the risk factors and the different types of concerns and other concerns related with the transgenics crops? Now, when we start to give introduction on the conventional breeding and transgenesis, first of all, we know the difference between these two types of breeding. Conventional breeding is an oldest type of breeding which are used by the farmer at the ancient time. Whereas in the transgenesis, the breeder, whereas in the process of transgenesis or in the transgenic crop breeding method, we are use those methods which in which we are using the different types of tools used in the plant biotechnology. Now come to the plant breeding, which we know that this is of two type, that is conventional breeding defined as identification and selection of desirable traits and transfer of these selected traits into the individual plant. Whereas transgenesis, in which we will develop the transgenic crop, which also called as genetically modified crops. In breeding process, following steps are generally used by the breeders. First, objective. Second, different types of variability. Then, selection. Then, evolution and release of the particular cultivar in the crop field. The question is raised, what do we understand by the process of conventional breeding and genetically modified crops, that is GM crops? And what are the goal of such type of breeding? The goal of conventional breeding or genetically modified crop breeding is that to develop the improved variety of the plants. They may be crop plant, horticulture plants, fruits, vegetable crops, etc. In the conventional breeding, the breeder cross, in the conventional breeding, the cross takes place between the plants having the relevant character, and then we will select the offsprings which having the desirable trait. Whereas in the genetically modified type of breeding, we will introduce a specific gene which having a specific trait which we required will transfer into the genome of the other crop. As a result, a transgenic crop will be formed which having the new additional features. For all such steps, breeder use the strategies to breed those cultivars whose genetic purity and the productivity should be sustainable in the natural system after the mating process. We will see the process of conventional breeding. That is, what are the main procedure opted by the breeders in the crossing between the two species of the plant. In this conventional breeding method, pure line selection have been selected by the breeder, where the process of hybridization takes place. That is, in the process of hybridization, desirable traits of the different plant lines combine together, and as a result of this, the heterogenic trait develop, which will be obtained by the breeder. This heterogenic trait give an hybrid line which show increase the vigor capacity. This mutation is the another method which induce spontaneously or artificial changes to develop the improved variety of the crops. The limitations of the conventional breeding are sexual incompatibility between the crop line to their wild species and the limitation of the specific selected trait and the gene coding. Once we enter into the new era, this conventional breeding generate the next step of the evolution in the plant breeding, and this step is called as transgenics era. In 1970 and in 1980, the emergence of molecular technique in the field of genetic engineering takes place. As a result of this, transgenics plants will be developed. These transgenics plants develop by the method which is called as agrobacterium mediated transformation. In this method, this bacteria is used to transfer the gene from one bacteria used to transfer the gene from the into the host plant cell. What has been done in this method, agrobacterium tumefaciens which carry a specific TI plasmid enter its DNA into the plant cell. As a result of this, recombinant DNA will take place. This recombinant DNA having all the specific trait which we want to require in the next generation of the plant, which should be transferred in the required plant. As a result of this, a new transgenics plant will take place. What are the main important of this GM methods in the current scenario? Now, we have already know that the limitation of the conventional breeding, which shows that conventional breeding method is limited between the specific selected trait and the gene coding. This, the use of transgenics method, we will bypass all these limitations of this conventional method. Here, the successfully cross takes place between the crops in which the gene of interest are present. It bypass the different kingdoms such as bacterium, or it might come from the different plant species. In a wild relative, there are some useful genes are present which should be identified and cross with the high yielding variety. As a result of this, a mixed genome of these two parent will form. Via using the modern molecular breeding technique, that is molecular assist breeding, we will destroy the unwanted combination of the gene in the high yielding variety. There are different regulatory processes for the transgenic crops. These regulatory processes are quite complex process. Under these process, different agencies are involved, which focus on the quality and effectiveness of the transgenics plant. In the transgenics crops are regulated at every stages in their development. That is, they have to tested at the field level, evaluated at the food level, also evaluated at the environmental level for the safety purpose. There are different types of regulatory bodies which regulate the release of the transgenic crops in the agriculture field. These important regulatory bodies work at in the coordination with national and international scenarios, and these bodies are IBC, that means Institutional Biosafety Committee. This committee is mandatory to establish in all the research institute where research being going on in the field of biotechnology, either in on animals or plants. Next regulatory body is Animal and Plant Health Inspection Service, which work under the USDA. Again, this body regulate and focus on terms and conditions of the transgenic crops to release in the market. Other one is Food and Drug Administrative Body, which screen the foods and different types of drugs before releasing into the market. Other one is Environmental Protection Agency, which regulate all these steps at the different level of the environment. That means once we release the transgenics in the cropping area or agricultural land area, what effect has been done on the ecology or environment of these crop. Next is the state regulation and international agreements. This type of body regulate the different types of rules of transgenic crop. And as we know that there are different types of regulatory body which regulate the transgenic crop, out of these regulatory body, the first most important body is IBC, that is Institutional Biosafety Committee. IBC committee is mandatory for all the research institute. This body regulate or monitor the potential of hazardous biological research in the particular research institute or the university and ensure fulfillment the biological safety procedure which are used in the laboratory research work. For the development of transgenics plant, we are using four different level of biosafety level. These levels are biosafety level 1, 2, 3 and 4. These biosafety level depend on the potential risk of the specific transgene. Biosafety level 1 basically restricted to the greenhouse area and those crops which are infected by the insects, weeds, etc. Biosafety level 2 follow all the requirement used in the biosafety level 1. Along with these, It also screened, it also restricted the movements of the small insect into the particular area. Further, in the biosafety level 2, if we want to remove the transgenics material outside the lab, in this case, we will autoclave this one first, that is to sterilize by the autoclave and then remove out from the lab. In the biosafety level 3, we are using special type of protective label. For example, we are using protective clothing, security fences, ventilation, proper ventilated filters, sealed windows and other accessories which protect the entry of the agents which show potential hazard. In the biosafety level 4, we are working for extremely hazardous agent which include certain exotic plant pathogens similar to the biosafety level 3, but they are more stringent. The other agency work as a regulatory body is Animal and Plant Health Inspection Service. This body work on the stability of plant chromosome, also study the non-pathogenic nature of the pathogen for the environment, non-toxicity to the organism, whether a transgenic plant variety having negative effect on the agriculture or environment. It also regulate the import, transport and field testing of the transgenic seeds and plants through notification. This regulatory body also help in the commercialization of the transgenics plant. The researcher formally request to this regulatory body. This regulatory body required an extensive data on the introduction of the gene construct from the researcher, their effect on the biological system, oblique ecosystem, including the spreading of the gene to the other crop and the wild relative. This regulatory body has the authority to remove the particular crop from the market if it found any adverse effect on any plant in the particular area. Regulatory body, that is Food and Drug Administration. This body work under the Federal Food, Drug and Cosmetic Act, which determine the safety of the food and food ingredients. This FDA staff consult with the plant developer and review the safety and nutritional data at the different level, that is at the toxicant level, their nutrient level, antibiotic resistant level, etc. And at the end of this, body send a letter to the developer which stated that agency is satisfied with the data regarding the food safety of the product. The EPA body, that is Environmental Protection Agency, has the authority to regulate transgenic as per under the three laws. The first law is the Federal Insecticide, Fungicide, Rodenticide Act, which granted the authority to regulate the distribution, sales, uses and testing of the plant and microbes containing the pesticidal substances. The other act is the Federal Food, Drug and Cosmetic Act. Under this act, it regulate the pesticide content in the food, or under this act, we can screen the pesticide content in the food or other food related substances. Under the Toxic Substances Control Act, different types of genetically engineered microorganisms, for example bacteria, that allowed a plant to fix nitrogen or produce a novel chemical. The regulatory body, that is state regulation and international agreement, work in the coordination with Animal and Plant Health Inspection Service, USDA, and it monitor the transgenic field testing. Now, come to the next important subtopic of this module is the transgenic crop which are currently available in the market. In the global way, different types of transgenic crops are available in the market. The most common crops are soybean, followed by the corn, cotton and canola, which has been shown in the graph A. We show global adaptation of the GM crops of soybean, cotton, canola and crop corn. Whereas in 1996 to 2002, the reported transgenic crops are soybean, corn, tobacco, cotton, canola, tomato and potato. These transgenic crops are resistant. These transgenic crop shows herbicide tolerance, that is, these herbicide transgenic plant have herbicide tolerance gene. Roundup, that is, which show resistance to the glyphosate. As a result, it show the broad resistant spectrum for this glyphosate herbicide. In this case, in the field, only those plant are able to survive which having the tolerance gene of this herbicide resistance. Bt insect resistant crops are available in the market. Bt shows Bacillus thuringiensis, which is a soil bacterium whose spores contain cry protein, that is crystalline protein. In this cry protein show adverse effect in the insect, that is, in the insect gut, the protein break down and release toxin product, which is known as delta endotoxin. This toxin bind and create pores in the intestinal lining, resulting in ionic imbalance, paralysis of the digestive system, and after the few days, death of the insects takes place. There are different versions of the cryogens are available in the market which work on different crops like cotton, potato, etc. In cotton, for these cryogen help to protect cotton crop from the tobacco budworm and the cotton bollworm, whereas in potato, this cryogen protect the potato crop for the collateral potato beetle. Now these days, this BT potato has been discontinued as a commercial product from the market, as it has been found out that it show adverse effect on the different order of the insects. There are cryogens which has been listed in the table shows Cry1A, Cry1AB, Cry1AC, and the toxic which introduce in the different insect order are Lepidoptera. Similarly, Cry2 work in Lepidoptera and Diptera. Cry3 work in Coleoptera. Cry4 work in Diptera. Cry5 work in Lepidoptera and Coleoptera. There are other transgenic trees species are available, and the most important transgenic species are poplar, eucalyptus, sweet gum, white spruce, etc., which show herbicide tolerance, insect tolerance, reduce the accumulation of lignin, etc. Now, the concerns, the risk and the concerns of the transgenics crop. After the introducing the transgenics crop in the market, it has been generated many negative consequences. There are following issues which has been released with the releasing of the transgenics crops. First, effect of such crops on the human health. Either it may be allergic, or in what way it affect the human system after eating the foreign DNA, having change in the nutritional level. Second, in what way affect the environment, that is issue on damage to the natural environment. That means those transgenics crops which having foreign DNA, in what way it causes changes in the ecology and the natural environment. What is the effect? Now, third one is, what is the effect in the soil if there is a leakage of the genetically modified protein into the soil? It means once this transgenics crop has been prepared and some genetically modified protein leakage takes place in the soil, then what way it affect the soil? Fourth one is, in what way this method affect the farming and food product practices in the developed countries? Now, the last is, in what this method affect the traditional practices and the economics in the less developed countries? So students, let us summarize what we have learned in this module. It means in this module we have to focus how agriculture biotechnology cross sectorial and interdisciplinary. That means in what way the agriculture biotechnology overcome the methods which are used in the ancient time, and in what way it affect the environment once we use the genetically modified crops. Biotechnology is a complement for many area for the conventional agricultural research. That means if we see the effect of biotechnological research, then we find out that conventional agricultural method are more competent if compared with the transgenic method. It offer a range of tool to improve our understanding and management of the genetic resources for the food and the agriculture. Genetic engineering in the crop required knowledge of genomics and protein. It means when we focus to use different types of genetic tools in the crop, we have good knowledge at the genomic and the proteomics level, so that we will develop a better and improved varieties of the crops which produce the good proteins which have the tendency to fight against the different stress conditions. The application of new molecular technology and new breeder strategies to the crop provide specific application to the smallholders in the developing country. It means if we use molecular technology or if we use genetically engineered practices in the production of agriculture land area, then we will develop some new important varieties or new we will develop some improved crop varieties for the small holders in the developed countries. The application of the biotechnology provides the researcher with the new knowledge that makes the job more efficient and effective. In this way, biotechnological based research program can be seen as a more precise extension of the conventional approach. With all these words, I would like to thank you, and I wish that you will get a good knowledge with these prepared slides.